Welcome, Waffle Waffettes. We are back with the brilliant Dead Island 2 on the PlayStation 5. And I hope you guys and girls are having an absolutely fantastic day. Now in the previous video, we arrived at Monarch Studios. We suffered a few unnecessary deaths, but we fought our way through the studios. And we are now relatively close to the location of Michael, who has came here to possibly collect something for Emma to try and impress her, because he doesn't like the fact that my character Ryan and Sam B have been taking all of her attention from him. So let's get straight into things. Now there's these weird things on the wall that are stuck everywhere, so I'm going to assume that we're either going to meet some sort of spitter or some sort of exploding zombie like you could find in the first game, but it could be something completely different, but I'm sure we'll find out.
Michael came in here. So did something else.
Very, very soon. But in terms of weapons, I've got a golf club with an upgrade, impact upgrade. We've got a police baton with an electric upgrade. We've got a dagger with a electric upgrade. And we've got this big old warhammer with a... It's like a bleed over time upgrade. But pretty damn good. We've got this one over here. Can't remember what this upgrade does, but a lot of these weapons are starting to get a bit old now because I think I'm... What level am I? I think I'm like level 10 or something. Possibly. I'm not sure. Might be level 10. I can't remember. Okay. I'm going to bring one of these with me just in case. It's always good to have one of these big old barrels of fire. Actually, have I got anything... Huh. Shouldn't matter. I think if you just poke these...
Oh, I see more of that goop.
I think if you just poke these fuel containers, they explode anyway. I don't think you need to even poke them with fire. That'll do, Piggy. That'll do. Take the elevator. Okay. I mean, I could already see... Where'd it go? I just looked at it. A control panel. So we already know that something is going to go on in this area. If we've got some sprinklers... It must be for that bit. How do we make the how do we make the lights fall down though? Where's the button for that? Oh, it might be over here. Nope. Oh, I don't know where the button is for that. It shouldn't really matter anyway. If we can set a nice big fire, then all of the zombies will walk into the fire anyway, and they're going to end up dead. So it'd be all good. I would like to find some sort of decent slashy weapon though, something like more like a scythe or a sword or a machete or something like that. Not so much these little daggers where he does the stupid pokey thing that he does. But something more choppy. Or an axe. An axe would be nice as well. I was playing off camera and I found a random green axe. Green quality axe. And it had a liquidator upgrade on it, which is basically corrosive acid all over it.
Well, I'll be going around then.
Alright, I think we've picked everything up. Okay.
We must have taken this elevator. Come on, come on, hurry up.
There we go. A nice big old chunk of meat food for my new friends, as the game quaintly put it. Yep, it does work. Okay. I was wondering if I'd need to get some sort of fire upgrade on my weapon. Ah, come on, you bastards. And they're all going to walk into it because there's still meat there. Oh, God. Oh, shit. He brought a bin with him. He brought me a present. Oh, fuck. These zombies are amazing. Because they flipping basically electrocute all of their friends. See? See? See what I mean? It'll come up. What are you attacking me for? I didn't do anything. See, what a bunch of idiots.
Finally, world's slowest elevator.
It's always funny when you're in an elevator that they seem to take absolutely forever to arrive. But then when you're sitting inside one, or standing inside one, I should say, you know, going down or up or whatever, they always feel relatively fast, don't they? Like, you seem to get where you want to go relatively quickly. Unless you're, like, in, like, the world's tallest building or something like that, then I think it does take a bit of time to get to the top. But just normal, everyday shopping centre elevators, they feel so slow waiting. But when you're inside it, it feels so quick. Giggity. Yeah, we could have electrocuted a bunch of those. Actually, we could have waited for that shocking zombie to arrive. Hang on a minute, this ain't an elevator.
It wasn't even a real elevator. I'm never telling anyone about this.
Oh, dear Ryan. Well, I might tell everybody. I might just tell everyone. Also, you're on YouTube, mate, so at least 10 people-ish will probably see this video. Maybe less. But yeah, I could have used that sprinkler system when that shocking zombie appeared. To be honest, I thought we were going to fight something big down there, like a boss. I still don't know if we're going to find Michael completely zombified, or whether he's going to be, you know, intact or just injured, or, you know, who knows. Michael doesn't seem like the strongest kind of guy, but, you know, who knows. When you're trying to impress a lady, you get a strength inside of you that you never knew you had. And that is a fact. It's crazy. Okay, we are rank 9. That's alright then. Space Fox 2250. Emma Jaunt don't feature in that movie. Oh my god, look at the state of that. Oh god, well, this ain't gonna be fun, is it? We don't have to fight no giant spiders. Imagine a zombie spider. Nah, I'm good. Alright, well, we're gonna be locked in.
Seriously, Michael, where the fuck are you?
I second that question. Right. There's a bunch of control panels everywhere, and I think there's another control panel in here. And this one detonates. Yeah, that detonates the meat truck. So what we could... the petroleum chuck over there. So I could chuck my meat bait over there and then just detonate it and fuck up a bunch of zombies. Alright. There should be some medical kits. I think they might be in here. Oh, there's one in here. There's probably one somewhere else. Okay, let's do this. Oh, don't walk over that. Don't want to burn ourselves. I mean, if there's a big old puddle of this crap here, I mean, that's already going to kill most of the zombies for me anyway.
Whatever I've been following is in there.
Emma Jaunt, The Rise of the God Spider. So he's come to Emma Jaunt's trailer.
Hey, Michael!
God, what are you doing here?
What are you doing here?
Me, I came to get... I'm... Oh, God. I think we're in trouble. Look out!
Oh, shit. Okay. Okay. Get out of here. I can handle... Yeah.
Whatever that is, we need to kill it.
Okay.
What is that? Oh, it's got a name. Oh, it must be an actor. Oh, shit. I don't know. Does it take damage from, like, venom?
You rain. Let's heat things up.
Okay, that turns on the pyro. This must be the spider's venom spitter.
Where's the shot?
Okay. So it looks like this new zombie type is a spitter. You can get the hell off of me. Might make a nice thumbnail, that, actually. If I can get you over here somewhere. I don't think they're going to follow bait, are they? Oh crap, why'd the bait go over there? God damn it. He wasn't close enough. God damn it. Well, we stunned him. And he's taking some pretty big damage, this guy. He's not like a bruiser. Crusher, I mean. Oh, this might work. We might be able to push him now. Yeah, that could work. Oh, for God. Ah, oh, shit. I threw the meat too... Flipping on the meat bounced off the... bounced off the bloody zombie. Oh, God. Oh, he's still alive. He's spitting at me. Filthy devil. Got a pipe bomb ready, though. Ouch. Oh, Jesus. Oh my God. Quick. Fucking hell. Oh yeah, actually, perfect timing. Perfect timing, perfect timing. I mean, there's way more zombies than are gonna actually walk over to that bait though. Oh, well, I think we killed at least three. Now, you missed it, didn't you? You lunged at me, you little shit. Oh, they do blow up. Those guys that have got the fire extinguishers on their back, they do... Oh, actually, I think there might be another fire over here. Ah, shit, he moved. Alright, isn't... Oh, watch out, watch out. To be honest, it's very hard to see at the moment. I'm trying to be very careful with how I'm swinging, because a lot of them have got these... fire extinguishers on their back. Yes! Right, a golf club is nearly down though. Oh, watch out, he's gonna pop. Oh shit, what was that? Get in the fucking fire. I love that, man. The drop kick is so good, even in Dying Light. Right, I think he dropped a blueprint. That might be the liquidator blueprint that allows you to put that melting corrosive, this stuff right here, all over your weapon. It's got to be that. I mean, it's the perfect enemy to get it from, ain't it? Yep, melee liquidator mod. But these are all like green quality as well. You'll find better blueprints as you play the game that will give you even better upgrades. Okay, do I want to speak to Michael right now? Yeah, we might as well speak to him. I've only got one medical kit though, so I do have to be careful.
Oh, God damn it! That was the worst one yet.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine, just a bit hot.
Wait, we went through all this for a fucking Romero?
Emma's Romero, but I, of course not. Look, medical supplies.
Is someone sick?
No. No, well, not yet. It's not like insurance is worth anything these days. We'll need these to, you know, keep us safe. I'm helping.
I'm sure they'll come in handy. So,
Emma means a lot to you.
She's given me more than I can ever repay. I can't be what she needs. I can't protect her.
She needs your advice. I got a plan, but she's not sure she can play her part.
She could do anything.
So tell her. Then we can all get out of L.A.
Sure. Okay.
Hey, you there? It's Sam B.
Sam, what's up?
Heard you was in the hills. Me too. Got a line on some gun.
Oh, I could use a gun.
No doubt. Come meet me.
I should take you back. Don't want you getting bitten.
Well, you don't need to worry about that, okay? I'll be fine. Just go get those guns.
Okay. If you're sure.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Michael.
Oh, nice. Oh, new Slayer card. Did it look like Michael was, like, holding his side a little bit then? Or was he just acting very, I don't know, starstruck because Ryan walked into the room and Ryan's an absolute legend, you see? But it did look like there was some blood in the sink. Like some bloody rags, maybe, or a bloody bear or something. It looked like there was some blood in that sink. Right. Okay, so this is the one we normally use. There's no stopping you. Attacks to knock down zombies get a minor boost to damage. Oh, yeah, well, we should definitely grab that. This one could be grabbed too. Hit them while they're down. Knock down a zombie for moderate boost to damage of your ranged way. Oh, well, that spoiled it. I mean, I know we are going to unlock a gun soon, but still. Oh, there's the flying kick ability. But I continue using the drop kick. Because there's going to be another skill card we're going to get soon that basically turns your drop kick into like a... I don't know what. But basically you can boot them like 3 times the distance. It's amazing. Around here. And especially for kicking them off of things like roofs and stuff like that. It is very, very good. And just how far they go. You can get them into fires. You can knock them away from you so they stop attacking you. It's just very, very useful. I do love the fly kick. You got it in Dying Light as well, didn't you? The drop kick, not the fly kick, the drop kick. Okay. Sorry I'm always looking around, but you have to in this game. You've got to make sure you always keep up with your resources. And sometimes you could find a high quality weapon in a room without even knowing. You know, it could just be a random blue sitting in a room for no reason. And you don't want to leave stuff like that behind. See what I mean? See? And that might be the axe I mentioned. Yeah, this is the one I found off camera. The Liquidator axe. So it's what you've got to look around. You just rush through the game and then you leave bad boys like that behind. It's an upgraded axe and it's the same level as me. So that's going to save me a bunch of resources and it's going to help me kill things. And I don't have to spend money buying a weapon or searching. It's great.
Back to reality. Radio.
They say Ryan.
Hey, this is Ryan Hero Services, cheapest in town.
Okay, it's clear you're alive. I have a friend who needs help. Any chance you could get to the Halpern Hotel, like, soon?
Oh, that place. Who's asking?
Hold up. I'm Hannah. I'm hunkered down with my BCLA buddies in the rental we share in the Venice Canals, but I've lost contact with one of them, Rav. He's a med student.
Sorry, but it ain't too hard to figure out why you lost contact.
You haven't seen the Bobcats in action. He's a survivor, and he's been making unique weapons. He'll make it worth your while.
No job too hopeless. Okay, I'll look for your friend.
Okay, I feel like we're going to have to do that at some point. If he's making unique weapons, you already know that that's going to be beneficial to us. So we'll probably have to do that at some point. Storage locker. Right, one thing I am going to do, though. I'm going to get rid of this weapon now. I'm going to disenchant it. Well, not disenchant, but scrap it, because it's too low level now, and it cost a fortune to upgrade it. I'm going to repair this, though. Lovely. And I'll keep some of these other weapons just to sell once we get back to Emma Jaunt's house. After we're done working with, actually, whilst I'm here. Make a couple of these bad boys. There we go. Lovely. I really hate opening doors in this game. Every time. Looks like one of those little Japanese toilets. Looks like the toilet that Randy Marsh has in the Japanese toilet episode in the new season. So tell you what, one thing that does really annoy me about the new seasons of South Park is they seem to be so flipping short. I don't know why, but they seem to be tiny. I swear back in the old days they used to make like 15 episodes to 20 episodes or something like that. At least 10 to 15. Now they seem to be like 5 or some shit like that. Don't know what's going on. It better be daytime now. I'm sick of the dark. Man, look at the curly hair on that guy. I should be able to record longer today because the teachers are striking in the school I work at. Also, the same school I live next door to. So there shouldn't be much noise. Only a few kids
Sam,
are able to come
back
in.
Beverly Hills. Where are these guns?
Me and Ronnie are headed to 12 Arc Hill Ridge. Meet you there.
But yeah, I should be able to record for longer because only the key worker kids are allowed to come into school. So yeah, should be able to record for longer today.
So Phil has the gate control room key, and he's somewhere in the waterworks. Gate control room.
Okay, so I need to press that button to let the boys in, Ronnie and Sam B.
Locked. Need to find a key, because of course I do.
Okay. Is that water down there? That's water, ain't it? There we go. Hey, you stupid runner. Oh, man. I love that. To be honest, I thought this bit, when I did this off camera, I thought this bit was optional. I came in here just thinking I found like another area. I didn't actually pay attention to the fact that I needed to let Sam and Ronnie in. Because I don't think they actually, did they tell you to let him in? I don't think they do. I'll leave that there for later in case we take damage. Oh. Oh, what's that for?
Something going my way.
I don't think we actually need this. I think we can just run through. There's a bunch of puzzly things we're going to have to do in this bit.
Need a valve wheel to stop the flow. That stopped the flow. Need some water to wash the caustic shit away.
There you go. And I'll wash away all of the acid on the floor. But you can literally just sprint through it. You ain't even got to worry. You can just absolutely leg it and you won't die. Obviously, you will take a bit of damage, but you won't die from it.
More caustic. Were they piping it around?
You know they're piping it around. They dumped a load of it inside the flipping drainage. You know, remember back in that swimming pool when we were heading to Major Booker and they chucked a load of it into the drains. So this corrosive, poisonous shit's probably all in the sewage system. Now, what am I looking for? Oh, yeah, I've already got it. There we go. Just remember, if any of the zombies are wearing the hazmat suits, they fucking idiots. They don't take any damage. Oh God, no! Get away from me. They don't take any damage from the corrosive acid, so do be aware. I love how they melt, man. The visuals in this game are. Oh, look at those. Oh shit! There's a crusher in there. Well, we don't want to go down there, do we? Well, actually, I think we need to go down there. That's we got a damn choice. Oh, that's to turn off the acid out there. Probably in case you ran through like a mad lad. Don't know why I've pulled out my big warhammer. This is actually underleveled now, so it's not much use. What are you low on health for? Oh, for God's sake! I wouldn't do that if I were you. What are you doing? What's the matter with you, Crusher, you fucking idiot? You're going to die before you get here, mate. You're lucky if you're going to get up the stairs. Oh, you just made it. Oh, I'll happily finish you off, buddy. He's got no eyeballs either. Oh, what's that? Oh! A wacky zaki, a wacky sashi. Oh, finally! We got ourselves a sword or something. It's a miracle, man. This video is going perfectly. I was complaining that we didn't have enough supplies. Enough light. Things like, I don't think I even need this battery. I think we're going that way, so I'll chuck it over there. But I was complaining at the start of this video that we don't have enough choppy weapons. And now we've found an axe and a flipping sword. Okay, it's going very well today.
Okay, got a breaker.
I'm going to assume there's a bunch of supplies in the acid. If you do, like, kill a bunch of enemies in the acid and they drop a load of stuff in there, like I said, you can run in there and pick it all up. You take, like, such a small amount of damage. It's not really a big deal. Oh, a heavy wrench. Oh, man, we've got a lot of level 10 weapons now. We're doing all right. We're in good shape. Oh, crap. Please clear the acid. Thank you. Lovely. Funny how their wallet didn't melt in the acid. You'd expect a wallet to melt pretty easily.
Need a breaker to get in.
way ahead of ya. Way ahead of ya. Right.
Bill?
I'm not going to use those two yet, because I want to upgrade them. So I'll keep that there for now. I'll switch back over to my trusty old Joel special for now. Is that a fireman? These ones are bastards. They don't take damage from fire. And if you've got a bunch of weapons with fire, they won't take damage from them either. So, yeah. Make sure you've always got at least a normal weapon with you, or an impact weapon, or a shock weapon. Because these flipping guys won't die otherwise, and you'll be screwed. You have to rely on just kicking them. Ow! That was pointless. How did the fire reappear? Oh! Do you like that, buddy? I think this weapon is pretty low level, though. What? But it's electric! What about the Joel special? Oh, yeah, that one actually, didn't it, buddy? Yeah. Yeah, you like that, didn't you? Bloody fire. Alright.
Oh, caustic everywhere. What the hell? Ooh.
Flow control. Left or right?
Oh my god, man. Stupidest things on the planet they are. Oh, they're level 10 as well. Shit. Have they all been level 10? I think they have. Well, these flipping firefighter walkers are immune to everything. Cheeky little devils. They're not immune to explosions, though. That's for sure. Did it kill them? Yeah, I think we need to go down that way first. There's a battery here, and I don't think you need it for anything at all. I suppose you could, like, throw this on the floor to cover the area in water and then chuck a battery at it to, like, create a trap. But for, like, actual puzzle purposes, you don't need that battery for anything. Because I was running around with that battery for a while, looking for where I could slot it. But, nope, there was nothing that I could find anyway. I might have been being blind, obviously.
Okay, looks like I need to set the right pressure level by using these valves, and that should lift the lockdown.
Okay, so it tells you up in the corner we need to have a power of 20, a pressure of 20, and there'll be various different valves with numbers on them. So you've got to do a little bit of maths.
Looks like I need the pressure to match the number on the tank.
Not sure what's actually shocking me. I'm not even that close to you. Alright, so we've got a 50 over here, and when you twist these valves, various different things can happen, like maybe some acid will start falling from the sky, stuff like that, so do be careful.
Hey, I matched the pressure.
Okay, so we've done the 21, now we need to do the 71. 20's already on. As you can see, water started now falling from the sky and there's electricity everywhere. But I think we can turn this off first, actually, and that should stop it. Although we're going to have to wait for the floor to dry up now. Is it drying up? I think it is. Oh, it dried up a little bit. It dried up enough. Oh, shit. There, see, and that's now turned on the acid. So various different things will happen. So be careful.
Oh, yeah. Not just a gorgeous body. That's lifted the lock.
Don't blow your own horn, Ryan. Jesus Christ, mate. Man, Ryan's a top character, isn't he? I don't know what the other characters are like in this game. They probably all say the same thing, but yeah, I like Ryan. Absolute legend. Okay. Let's get my meat out ready. Giggity. Which one's Phil? Is it? I'm taking it's the big guy, isn't it? I'll go on melt Phil. Oh yeah, that's the crushers, Phil. That's bollocks, Phil. Oh, he's mad. Oh dear, Phil. Oh shit, mate, you got annihilated, Phil.
Okay, now I can get the fuck out of here.
Not yet. I think I saw some loot down there. We don't leave any loot behind. Oh, of course there's a flipping fireman down there. You son of a bitch! Oh shit, where'd you lot come from? Now these fucking runners are so quick, aren't they? And you won't be doing this anymore once I get my sword upgraded, because I'll be taking off all your limbs, buddy. And I always go for the legs. Always. Because if going for the arms is alright, but if they've still got their legs, they can still run around and they can still dodge and they can still sort of like lunge at you and stuff and bite you. Arms obviously makes it, if no arms, makes it easier, but just taking their legs off and having them waddle around on the floor is great. And sometimes you can just cut their leg off and leave them. Like what you do in Resident Evil 2 when you're trying to conserve ammo on like hardcore. Shoot their legs that are on the floor and just leave them. Just leave them there to suffer. Okay, don't think we left anything behind. We can grab that that medical kit on the way out. Lovely. Oh yeah. Don't want to leave you behind, babe. Mwah. Alright. It's going to be a bit awkward because I'm not going to be able to start the actual section collecting the guns because I've only got about 5-ish minutes left. So I could walk down there, but I'm not going to be able to start the mission until the next video.
Hey, this is Sam. We're almost there.
I'm on my way.
Nice. Oh, empowering perk. Sweet. Well, at least we can start upgrading some of our good weapons now. Right, 10, 10, 10, 9, 9, 9, 9. Bloody hell, man, all our weapons are pretty high level. Well, we could probably disenchant you now, unfortunately. I'll get rid of you as well. I'll sell some of the other stuff, but we're going to upgrade this bad boy. What do we want to put on this? I'd say fire, because we ain't got no fire weapons at the moment. So we'll get some fire on it, and we'll get this bad boy on it as well. Fabricate. Lovely. Because it increases limb damage and increases the durability. Lovely. And as for this, I think we'll put electricity. Oh, we can't. Oh, what do we want? Impact or bleed? I mean, traumatizing them is good because I think they just stop moving for a bit. It, like, knocks them out, maybe. Sort of stuns them, kind of. We'll go with a bleed. I think bleed's better for, like, the more stronger enemies. We don't really need that. We're not going to go for the limbs. We'll go with that. There we go. Then we can charge up our heavy attacks quicker. And that should do for now. Pick up the fucking scrap. What's the matter with you? Why aren't you picking up the scrap? And why did you chuck some on the floor? Stop wasting my supplies, Ryan. You absolute menace to society. Oh, chemicals. Tell you what, man. Every time I see bottles of chemicals like that, I get a little bit triggered. Because obviously I'm a cleaner, for those of you that don't know. I have two cleaning jobs. I clean an entire junior school. Primary school. Yeah, junior school. And I have to deal with cleaning toilets and shit. And the bleach splashes on my clothes occasionally. And you know what it does? It leaves these little marks over all my flipping clothes where it's just worn away the colour. So I have these like white patches or these like brownish sort of patches. Just because the dye has been worn away by the bleach. Absolute menace. I saved my new weapons for when we get down here and we meet up with... Oh, I wonder. Oh, there was people down there. I was just wondering if we could get it through the hole. Giggity again. I've been saying giggity a lot in this video. I've been a right filth bag today, ain't I? I was hoping we could get it through the hole. Didn't even know there were zombies down here. Oh, look, Barry survived. Oh, it's a woman. Sarah survived. Look how you cleanly dodged the fire. Couldn't dodge my feet, though, could you, love?
Hey, over here.
Yeah, well, you're going to have to wait, mate. Not very long, literally about 4 seconds, whilst I stop this video and start a fresh recording. But yeah, I'm going to have to end the video now, Wolf and Wolfette. So thanks for watching, Wolf and Wolfette. Hopefully you enjoyed this one. I think we got quite a few things done today. We took down I guess it's a boss, but it's just like the introduction to a new enemy, really. Because we're going to start seeing spitters from this point onwards. But we dealt with the boss. We found Michael. We opened up a gate for Sam B. And in the next video, it looks like we're going to get some guns, which is very good in this game, actually. The guns are pretty damn strong. But yeah. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed. Like, share, and join the pack today.